Hello everyone, assalamualaikum, welcome back to my channel. It's me, Dr. Shahnaz Jannat, and today I'm going to talk about classification of joint. So we can classify our joint in many ways. We have structural classification, we have functional classification, and we have biomechanical classification. So now let's see structural classification. Structural classification is according to their structure. According to their structure. Now, according to their structure, we have three types of joints. One, two, three, and these are fibrous joint, then cartilaginous joint, then synovial joint. Now first let's see what is fibrous joint. Fibrous joint is a type of joint where bones are connected by tough or dense fibrous connective tissue. Suppose this is one bone and this is another bone. Now these two bones are connected by a dense or tough fibrous connective tissue. So this is fibrous joint. Now fibrous joint can be subclassified into three types. And fibrous joints are suture joint, we can find them in between two skull bones, then syndesmosis, suture joint, syndesmosis joint, then gomphosis. So these are suture joint, syndesmosis, gomphosis. These are fibrous joint. Now let's see cartilaginous joint. Cartilaginous joint is where two bones are connected with cartilage. Suppose this is one bone and this is another bone. Now, in between these two bones, fibrocartilage or hyaline cartilage is present. So, this bone connected each other with fibrocartilage or hyaline cartilage. Now, cartilaginous joint can be subclassified into two types. And these are synchondrosis or primary cartilaginous joint, where bones are connected with hyaline cartilage. Then symphysis or secondary cartilaginous joint, where bones are connected by fibrocartilage. Now let's see synovial joint. Synovial joint, this is the most common type of joint in our body. Suppose this is one bone and this is another bone. Now in between these two bones, or these two bones are connected with by this synovial layer, and this synovial layer is filled with synovial joint. So because of this synovial fluid, this joint can freely movable. So this is the freely movable joint. Now synovial joint can be subclassified into 6 types. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And these are ball and socket joint, then hinge joint, condyloid joint. Condyloid joint is also known as ellipsoid joint. Then pivot joint, then saddle joint, then plane joint. So these are synovial joints. Now let's move on to our functional classification. Functionally, we can classify them. Now we have 3 types of joints. 1, 2, 3. So this classification is according to their function. Different degrees of movements. And these are synarthroses. Synarthroses joint. Then Amphiarthrosis joint, Diarthroses joint. Now, synarthrosis is a freely movable joint. Now, synarthrosis is immovable joint. Immovable joint, where no functional movement is allowed. So suture joints, then gomphosis. These are the example of synarthrosis. So synarthrosis joint is also like a fibrous joint. Now let's see amphiarthrosis. Amphiarthrosis joint, these are slightly movable joint. For example, these are also like cartilaginous joint, like secondary or symphysis joint, or secondary cartilaginous joint is the example of amphiarthrosis, or also syndesmosis. Syndesmosis, this is fibrous joint, but this joint allow slight movement. So this is the example of amphiarthrosis joint. Syndesmosis. Now let's see diarthrosis. This is the freely movable joint. Freely movable joint. So all diarthrosis joint is synovial joints. So these are the example of diarthrosis. They can freely movable. For example, shoulder joint. Shoulder joint. Now example of a synarthrosis is coronal suture, amphiarthrosis, pubic symphysis. Now let's move on to our last type of joint, biomechanical joint. Biomechanical joint is according to their articulation surfaces. According to their articulation surfaces or number of bones present in the joint. Now biomechanically we have three types of joints. Simple joint, then compound joint, then complex joint. Now, a simple joint is where present two articulation surfaces. Two articulation surfaces. For example, shoulder joint. Then compound joint is where three or more articulation surfaces. For example, radiocarpal joint. Radiocarpal joint. Then complex joint, where two or more articulation surfaces and an articular disc or meniscus present. This is complex joint. For example, knee joint. Knee joint. So these are our classification of joint. Now we have We can classify them in three ways: structural classification, functional classification, biomechanical classification. Now, structurally, we have fibrous joint, cartilaginous joint, synovial joint. Fibrous joint joints are sutures, syndesmosis, gomphosis, and cartilaginous joints are synchondrosis or primary cartilaginous joint, where hyaline cartilage is present, then symphysis or secondary cartilaginous joint, where fibrocartilage is present, then synovial joints are ball and socket joint, hinge joint, condylar or ellipsoid joint, pivot joint, saddle joint, plane joint. Then functionally we have synarthrosis, immovable joint, then amphiarthrosis, slightly movable joint, diarthrosis, freely movable joint. Then biomechanically we have simple joint, compound joint, then complex joint. So this all about our classification of joint. I hope this video will help you to understand joints easily. So in my next video I'll talk about more details about joints. Till then, take care. Allah Hafiz.